This is an elephant seal photographed on the coast of California, about 80 miles south of San Francisco. And this is a rookery that belongs to that previous elephant seal. The females come ashore to give birth, and you can see the little, there's quite a few young ones there, the little black figures right next to the larger ones are actually little babies. And this is in the same area. Here we have a great egret. This was photographed in Smyrna, Delaware. The egret had just taken flight and was going, it's water in the background, and it was just flying around, and I happened to catch it while it was flying. These are snow geese, and this was photographed in New Mexico, about 80 miles south of Albuquerque, in an area called Bosque del Apache. And the mountains in the background are the Chupadera Mountains. This was actually photographed in the latter part of the day, just a little about an hour before sunset. And the snow geese are coming into the fields to roost and to feed. This is just a little closer view of the snow geese, and you can see the cornfields. The farmers there leave the fields after the corn has been picked. They leave the fields alone rather than plow it. They leave it this way so that the snow geese can feed. And they're there by the thousands. I was there for just a couple of days and literally saw over 10,000 snow geese each day. And here we have barn swallows. I was lucky enough to catch the adult feeding the baby. The others are just waiting their turn. This was taken in a barn in Falmouth, Massachusetts. And here we have two parakeet auklets. This was photographed in Alaska, actually off the western coast of Alaska in the Bering Sea. This was on top of about a 200-foot cliff, and the two birds were just greeting each other. And also in Alaska, of course, is a grizzly bear. This was taken in the southern part of Alaska. The catmite, yeah, they are. They're known as the Katmai Peninsula. And these are two sandhill cranes. This was also photographed at that Bosque del Apache area in New Mexico. And the killdeer was on a nest, and when he saw me approach, he did what they call the broken wing act that the bird is famous for. He makes a belief one of his wings are broken and scuttles along the ground so that you will follow him and just leave the nest alone and forget where the nest is, because it's pretty well camouflaged. And the snipe was photographed in Concord, Massachusetts. And he actually had some babies there with him, but they were pretty well hidden. And here we have a goshawk over a ring-necked pheasant. The goshawk was hunting and just nailed the pheasant. And when a bird of prey hits another bird, or hits his prey, he does what they call mantling. That's spreads his wings out so that nobody can see, no other animal can tell that he has something there. Otherwise, they would come in one and join in on the feast. And then after a while, he starts eating. This is a New Hampshire foliage scene. taken on the way up to Pittsburgh, New Hampshire. And this is a typical winter Vermont scene in East Orange, Vermont. This is supposedly the most colorful church in Vermont, right in East Orange. This is a great gray owl that came down to Rowley, Massachusetts a few winters ago. The bird is typically found in northern part of North America, Canada and Michigan, that area, but every once in a while, if things get, hunting gets tough up there, they make their way down. And it was kind of unusual to see him in Rowley, but he was there almost for the whole winter. And here we have some fox kits outside the den. This was taken in Middletown, Rhode Island. I had to wait for a while in the sand dune. Den is in the sand dune with the ocean on the other side. And I had to sit down and wait for a while for them to get familiar with me before I can attempt to take any photographs. But they were playing around after a while and just paid no attention to me, so I just got some good shots. Lucky enough to get some good shots. This is a waterfall in Colebrook, New Hampshire. It's called Beaver Brook Falls. Very colorful waterfall. Beautiful area. This is another waterfall. This was in Massachusetts, in Sunderland, Massachusetts. Actually in somebody's back, well, almost their backyard. But I wanted to get a winter scene of a waterfall. Everybody shows, you know, waterfall during the summer and the spring. And I thought it was quite nice in the winter with the ice formations and the snow all around it. And we have more cranes, more sandhill cranes in New Mexico. That other waterfall, by the way, is called Whitmore Falls in Sunderland. Here we have a flock of snow geese coming in to land in the water from their roost. This will give you an idea of just how many there are there. It's a tremendous area. They stop in this particular area during their migration, both sandhill cranes and snow geese, and you see them by the thousands. This is a photograph of a mother loon feeding the baby. It was taken in New Hampshire, in a town called Northwood, New Hampshire. And this is a great blue heron rookery photographed at sunset. This particular rookery is no longer there. This was in Concord. This is not the rookery that people know about that's on Route 2 in Acton. But this was behind the school in Concord, and this was taken a couple of years back. And that whole area has been built up with new homes, and of course, everything is gone now. The encroachment of man. It's a black and white photograph taken a few years back. I just happened to like this. There was the only light in the building was coming through a window where the young woman was sitting, and it just struck me as being a very good moody shot, if I could keep the light like that. I had to keep the door closed with my foot so that nobody else would come in for the few seconds it took me to take the photograph. No flash, just regular light, natural light coming through the window. And it was taken at Sturbridge Village a few years back. White-tailed deer photographed at Baxter State Park. The deer actually had one young one behind her, but he wouldn't come out behind the grass. You could make him out every once in a while. He would kind of peek out and then go back in. But the mother came by early morning. This is a burrowing owl. This was photographed in Florida.
That was in the ground?
Yeah, they nest in the ground. Quite small. And a boreal owl. This is a very rare owl to be seen in this area, but it was actually on Commonwealth Ave in Boston, and it was there for a couple of weeks, roosting in a pine tree right next to one of the apartment buildings on Commonwealth Ave. And a snowy owl, photographed at Logan Airport. They're beautiful birds. One of my favorite birds is a snowy owl. And a barred owl sleeping, photographed in New Hampshire. The owl did eventually wake up and open its eyes, but I kind of like this shot. And a short-eared owl. This was photographed in Massachusetts, in Salisbury, Mass., right in Salisbury State Park. And let's see. This mountain goat was photographed in Glacier National Park, northern Montana. It was a long hike in. It was about, we drove up about, 3,000-4,000 feet on a 6,000 foot mountain. Was very, very high, and then had a hike in on the trail for about 3 miles before we came across the goat. There was a few goats that were higher up than we were, but they were working their way down while they were feeding, so with a little luck we just waited, and this one came. This was a beautiful specimen. He came down within a photographic range. And the bull moose. This was photographed in Pittsburgh, New Hampshire, just at the Canadian border. They are big when you get close to them. And this is a mother moose with her calf. Also in Pittsburgh, New Hampshire. This was photographed the first week in October. And here we have some mute swan cygnets along with their parents. The male is the one with the larger knob at the bridge of his nose. The female has a much smaller one. And the cygnets, of course, out here. And the loon with two little babies following. This was also done at Bow Lake, a different time than the other loon that was feeding its baby. But it was a nice area. I don't know if they still nest, if they're still nesting up there every year now. They were for a while. This is Mendenhall Glacier in Juneau, Alaska. And a wood duck. Manchester by the Sea, Massachusetts. These are Atlantic puffins photographed on an island about off the coast of Jonesport, Maine, called Machias Seal Island. This is taken in southern New Jersey. It was the winter time, and I was trying to get a sunset when I saw a flock of snow geese quite a distance away, and it was quite cold. I had my car engine running to keep warm, and the door open, and I was just waiting and hoping that the flock of snow geese would fly in this direction so I can get them in the shot, and that's what made it. I lucked out, and they came around, and I took the picture, and there it is. This was in Alaska. That's the Alaska Range Mountains in the background. This is just before you get into Denali National Park. Young elk lying down, resting. His parents are nearby. This was photographed in Alaska also. And caribou, also in Alaska. And here we have some more foxes. It's the mother fox with the little cub. Yeah, this fox kit was probably a couple of weeks older than the other three that you saw earlier. And this is a winter shot of the same area in East Orange, Vermont. Taken just about at the same vantage point. The photograph was actually taken from a hillside on the other side of the street. We're looking for a good vantage point to look down into the valley and at the church. There's a great blue heron. This was taken in Concord, Massachusetts. The heron, I believe, is going to be standing on a muskrat mound. Taken in the early fall. Yeah, huge, magnificent birds. And here we have a spicebush swallowtail butterfly on a lantana plant. Very colorful butterfly. Unfortunately, the glare in these photographs are not doing them any justice. The coloring is really very deep, very rich color. And here we have what we call Nootka lupine. This was photographed in Alaska. This particular variety of lupine doesn't grow much taller. This is a series of a few shots that I call Nature Sings the Blues. Everything is different shades of blue. Here we have a California garter snake. I don't know if anybody's ever seen a blue snake, but this is one. And a little blue heron, photographed in the Everglades, Florida. And a poison arrow frog. Small blue frog, the natives in South America use these frogs to dip this. They exude a poison, toxic poison from their skin, and they dip their arrowheads in when they go hunting. Of course, whenever the arrow hits, the poison penetrates and helps kill the prey. They're very small, they're only about 2 inches long. This is a great hyacinth photographed in Maine. I've had a few batches of this great hyacinth, different shade of blue. It's almost like a pink purple, like a periwinkle.